the mad mates, mad lads they were. They pulled it off, everybody. DC pulled it off. They were able to make a amazingly good film. I'm not trying to say that's sarcastic. I actually had faith in this film when I first saw it, because it looked like it was trying to be its own thing. Like, it didn't try to copy Marvel, it was just trying to have its own fun. And to no surprise, it was what I expected, a very, very good film. And so basically what I want to get into this fact is that basically this whole thing, this whole video, is not basically, I guess it's going to be a review, but not really that much a review. Solely review, probably like my opinion on the film, which is, I guess, kind of review, but whatever, I'm probably going to cut this apart anyway. So anyways, my opinion on the film is that it's basically the better Captain Marvel. It's marvelous, if I have to say. It's a marvelous DCEU film, because it's its own thing. It's not trying to copy Marvel, it's its own thing. And you may think that I'm not, you may think that I'm wrong, but if you go to this film, you may think it's just gonna be like a regular, superhero film. And my sister next to me thought that this was gonna be like a stupid film just with them trying to copy Marvel. No, it's its own film, and when she saw it, she was basically blown away, because she had expectations that were thinking that it was gonna copy Marvel, but not really, no. Like, yeah, there's jokes in here and there, but they land well. And this whole film, it's not just a soul superhero film. It's more or less a family film, because its whole premise is on family, and it shows. Yeah, Billy Benson, Billy Batson, aka Shazam, trying to find his mother, and who he doesn't wanna. He just thinks that he doesn't need the family, but then at the end of it all, he starts to realize that family. He realizes the fact that family is good, because he thinks he doesn't need it, but as the movie progresses, the character development of like him seeing family, and then what's very, very unique about these movies is the fact that Shazam and Savannah, the hero Shazam, the hero, and Savannah, the villain, they have these two conflicts with family. Like Billy, Shazam, he's trying to like not want, like they have these two families, but they go separate paths. Like Billy finds love and care, while Savannah just doesn't find any of that. His own father mocks him in the first scene, the first few scenes of the film. His father mocks him. That is not parental love. And that's what I like about this film, is that it captures the essence of family more than it does the superhero part. And I'll get into that, like, right now. And what I mean by the human part is the family part, the family essence as well. And what I mean also the family essence, I mean also the whole Billy's relationship between all the family members that are foster children. Like his relationships with the little sister, his relationship with his disabled brother / friend. And as well, like, you don't see it that, and then also the older sister that he, these three, like, he has these relationships with people, with these three people, and he doesn't think of them that much at the beginning, but then later on as the movie progresses, he sees them as a family, as well as the two foster parents that basically adopt him, and he basically sees that they are family. He starts to see that, and that's what I like about the human part of it. It's like, the director was able to show on that he was able to show a family film in the essence of a superhero film, conflicting of him. It's like showing that as well. And what's good about that is that you get to see that these characters, because in my opinion, DC movies, the one from the DCEU, they don't show human sides at all. And what I mean by human sides, I mean they don't show them like they're human. No one in the DCU doesn't feel human. Man of Steel, Superman, he does not feel human. You don't see him feel human. Batman v Superman, Batman doesn't seem, even though he's supposed to be human, he doesn't seem human. It was Batman, as well as Wonder Woman in that film. But then, Suicide Squad, no one felt human. Then Wonder Woman, then that's when humanity and human essence started popping up. But then in the next film, Justice League, yeah, there's human parts in it, but it doesn't feel like they're human. Then in Aquaman, they were able to show about the two sides of Arthur. They were able to show the two sides of him, and they're able to like mash up the human side and the Atlantic side, and then even though it was not that, even though they were able to like spot on it, they were able to show it. But then in this one, they were able to spotlight it in the essence of the film, because the human side takes a big toll on the superhero story, and that's what I want to say about the human side. And I'm gonna get into the villain right now. The villain, Sivana, they were able to make his villain compelling. Like Marvel, yeah, they had their villains, but this one, Sivana, yes, his toll and his reason to why he wants does make sense. Because in the first scene of the film, you get Sivana's backstory and how he became the bad guy and the holder of the seven deadly sins. You get to be able to see that. And then you can see how like his family treated him, which is the big part of the whole family part. Because family, like I said, is a big part of the whole film. The family, his family, do not like, they basically bully him. And that what leads him to this dark path, into freeing the seven deadly sins and taking it and then killing he kills his brother, then he kills his father. And the thing is that his whole reason why he does it is makes sense. Like, he's trying to get revenge of the people who look down on him. He makes sense, as well as the fact that they're his family. And then that contrasts with Bill's Batson's side of family, because his family give him support and they give him love, and that's what helps him lead into becoming what he becomes. Shazam, he becomes the hero, he becomes the one that finds a family. Wow, just wow. Congratulations, DC. Congratulations on your big W on this whole comic book movie thing shindig. Congratulations, DC. And here's to more DC films like Shazam. Here's to more DC films that will be good. Here's to those that don't try to compare and try to copy Marvel. Here's to those that be their own thing. Here's to those that doesn't need to be fit in a universe. Here's to those that are like...